Welcome back, YouTube. Don here again with Eastern CT Vapor. Okay, today's video, we are going to take a break from the reviews. All right, this particular video is going to be one of two parts. Okay, this is going to entwine with my Kennedy 22 review. Okay, what I'm going to do is review the Kennedy with fused Clapton coils on it. But this part one of two, I'm going to show you how to build the fused Claptons, okay? So why don't we take a dive down to the table, okay? I'm going to show you the supplies that we need for this build, and then I am going to go step by step, and I will show you exactly how to build a fused Clapton. We need to dive down to the table, but what do we always do before that, ladies and gentlemen? Hit the credits. And here we are down at the table, ladies and gentlemen. Our pile of supplies, okay? What this includes is, of course, our cutters, always needed. Okay. Set of pliers and or tweezers will work. A little fuzzies in there. Okay. A bit set to wrap our coils around and also screwdrivers for our atomizer. All right, we will also need 26 gauge canthal. This will be our core wire, and we will be claptoning these wires with a 36 gauge nichrome 80. Okay, there will be a link in the description where you can find most of those supplies. Okay, and finally, the big one, our drill. Let me back this up a little for you guys. Our drill. I am using a corded drill, cordless, corded, whatever suits your needs. Okay. The main thing that you need is for the drill, though, is one that has these, the chuck on it with these teeth so that you can open, put your wires in, tighten down. Okay. Preferably, you're going to want to drill with a hair trigger so you can slowly hit it and go for if you their wish. Sorry, go full if you there wish. I know that was loud. Also, you're going to want to drill with a forward and reverse. Well, that's forward and that's reverse, as the sticker says. Okay? So now we have seen the supplies needed for this build. Why don't we get started? First, what we are going to need to do is take our 26-gauge canthal. Okay? Obviously, they are secured so your wires don't move. We need to unsecure this. Okay. And you're going to want to pull enough wire for two coils. Oh, heck, I'd probably say 8 to 10 inches should do the trick. And the way that I see that that comes is where you take the line out of the spool, go one full roll of the spool, and then a half. And that should do the trick for you. And that was my one wire, and like I said, you can see our notch there where we started, so let's go to there and a half. All right. We can put that in there, secure this just a little bit. Turner 2 works. Go on ahead and trim that wire, and we are now all set with our canthal. We have have two nice strips, nice lengthy strips. And what you are going to need to do, very important, is straighten the canthal. Okay, if you're not sure how to do that, I will show you right now. And the way we straighten our canthal, we're going to take the end here and put a little 90 degree bend in it. Very small little piece at the end. Put a little 90 degree bend. And the reason we do that is because now we're going to go to the chuck of our drill. And as we tighten off, move this some so you can see it. You're going to want to put that bend into one of the teeth, into the edge. And that's just a safety measure, because some drills don't tighten down fully in the center. So you put that little bend in, so it definitely will grab nice and tight. And you want to keep your canthal centered in those teeth on the outside. Which, let me tighten this up and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Okay, get it nice and tight. And like I said, make sure it's nice and centered in those teeth right there. Okay, right in the middle. Alright. What we need to do next, I'll try and move this so we can see it. I really don't have the room, unfortunately. What we need to do, though, is take our pliers. And I know I have this a little bent, but what we need to do is take the end here and pinch down with our pliers, just like so, okay? And pull this wire, get all the slack out of it. Put it nice and tight like you see me doing here, see? See that wire's nice and tight? And what you want is the drill to move clockwise in this position. If it was the other way, it would be counterclockwise, depending on if you're left or right-handed. The way that I wrap wire, it looks like it's left-handed for some reason. Everybody that I've seen wrap wire is the other way. But whatever floats your boat. I mean, you could honestly even spin this wire whatever way you want, whatever you're comfortable with. Okay, I go counterclockwise like so, pulling all the tension out of the wire, holding down tight on our pliers, spin it for 3 to 5 seconds, full blast. Okay, and slowly let off on your pliers. You can undo the chuck of the drill. Get that piece of wire out, and as you can see here, I'll run it down my hand, straight as an arrow. Straight, 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 straight. That is how we straighten canthal. Do that with your second piece of canthal, and we will meet back here at the table for the next step. Now that we have both our strips of canthal here, nice and straight, we want to keep our 36 gauge nichrome 80 handy for this next part, because we are going to start claptoning these wires. Alright, what we need to do next, though, we can move this but keep it close by, is take our ends that we bent for the chuck of the drill. Now the easiest way to do this is put these wires next to each other like you see me doing here, but have your bends facing away from each other like so. And the reason we're going to do that is so each bend here goes into a different slot of the chuck. Okay, and I'll show you what I mean here in a second. As you can see, as we slide this open some, and see how I have one coming out this side and one coming out this side? That's what you're going to want to do. Go ahead and tighten down on this. And I will go up close in a moment so you can see how it's supposed to look. Okay, we'll pick this up here. And as you can see, these wires are sitting right next to each other. Okay, nice and parallel. We have one end coming out here, one end coming out here. Okay, pretty well centered in the chuck. You can go a little bit off the side, because I've noticed if you put two wires right in the center, they're going to want to almost make a V shape. So if you just kind of cockeye it just a little bit, you don't want to go too much, or else you're going to have this wire waving back and forth. If you go just a little bit, though, it helps to settle these wires next to each other. And what I like to do now is, this is where some people will take their nichrome 80 their outer wire, if you want to call it that. And what people will do is, you can do this, is take, say, 10 to 15 feet. I think it's something more like 10. I've never really done it this way. But you can unroll about 10 feet, cut it, and Clapton it that way. But the way I like to do this is just take one end here, which it's still secured. We can pop that out. Okay, now that that's out, I like to take this spool of wire, and as I unroll it here, I'm going to put this spool into my lap, but I want it to face this way in my lap, so the wire is coming off the top, okay? Here we go. Okay, so here's the end. You can barely see this nichrome. I'm trying to show it in the glare, but I'm taking the other end and unspooling it and bringing it down to my lap, okay? Sitting right in between my legs. And what I'm going to do next is where, sorry, I bumped the camera, right where the tooth of, right at this side tooth where the wire comes out, I'm going to stick this Nichrome 80 down in between there, okay? I'm going to feed it as best as possible, okay? And what I like to do next is very lightly hit the trigger of the drill and start to get a basic spin. Don't worry if this is perfect, because this is just our starting anchor. And next, what you're going to want to do, try to make this as close as possible. I like to take, I know this is close, is with my fingers, is if you lay your hands flat like this, take your ring finger and pick it up, okay? Pick your ring finger up and slide that behind your ring finger. Okay, like so you can see there's my pointer, middle finger, it goes behind my ring finger and then across the pinky. Now with that wire stuck between our fingers there, you can see I've got a light start there, and we're going to slowly start to spin this wire. I've always learned you want to keep tension on it, because if you lose that tension, they can start to overlap each other. If there's tension, at least a decent amount of tension, if it wanted to overlap each other, it would pull itself down, at least if it caught it lightly at the edge. Now this is something that after a while you just learn the feel of it. See how that's looking. You know, see how at the beginning there we had a little bit of a gap. Like I told you, that didn't matter. That's going to be an end we're probably going to cut off. But you can see it's starting. I know it's looking a little grainy. I apologize. I got this on full zoom right to the end, so. But you can see now we're getting rid of that gap. This beginning end really isn't that big of a deal, because like I said, this is going to be an end that's most likely going to get cut off. Let's scooch this down a little bit more. And the more you learn the feel for it, the faster you'll be able to go. And as I said before, keeping it between your, it's not between, laying your fingers out and putting it underneath your ring finger and then laying it across the top of your pinky, middle, and pointer finger and then letting it run behind your ring finger. You can kind of control a lot of the tension with your ring finger, because as you spin this, as I can show you, I have my fingers all laying flat. Okay, so this is, as it's spinning, the tension stays there because it now starts to pull it through that weave of my fingers. And I, this is a perfect example. I just overlapped a little bit. And what you can, it's not the end of the world if you overlap. Throw your drill in reverse and back it up just a little bit. And see, now that's off. Flip it back. and keep on going. Always keep in tension. Overlapped it again. I'm just sitting back it up, flip it again. It can be a little tedious if you're still learning. Like I said, you can see in this part here, I had a little bit of gaps. It was the start, but you can see here, it's all nice and lined up. Okay. And the smaller your gauge wire that you're wrapping this in, the longer and the harder it's going to be. Because with a smaller gauge wire, it has a lot more potential to overlap itself. Would be much easier for it. Plus, with a smaller gauge wire, it's going to have to wrap a lot more times. So, it's going to go a lot longer. I'm going to get just to the end of the frame here. And, that's a pretty decent chunk that I've shown you guys how to Clapton. So I'm not going to do the entire line because we'll be here for an hour. Doing this on camera is a little tricky. As you can see, I keep overlapping. But slow and steady wins the race with this, ladies and gentlemen. No need to be in a hurry. You're better off to take it slow. All right, guys. You've seen me now, like I said, it was a little bit gappy here. We were just getting started, but it's nice and smooth and lined up here. I'll even flip it a little bit with me. And you can see how nice and wound up it is. All right. So I'm going to do the rest of this off camera, but you've seen me do a nice little inch section here or so. Okay. So it's the same thing going throughout it. You know, it would just be me wasting video here going longer and longer. So we're going to do the rest of this off camera. If you need a pointer on it, just go ahead and rewind. That's the best that I'm going to do because with me being this close up, I can't get a whole lot on there. So, enough said. We will see you back when this Clapton is done being wrapped. And just to wrap this up, I wanted to show you guys how to end on the fused Clapton while wrapping it, what you should do. Okay, I am right at the end of one of two wires. You'll see as I spin this. So as we get to the end here, what you can do. You can see the end of that wire. Let me move up just a little bit for you. Okay, you can see the end of that second wire. Now, what I like to do is at least wrap that far. Which we'll finish doing here. Alright, now we're over that hump. I've gone a little extra. You could go all the way to the extra here. If you went all the way to the end of that wire right there and did that whole little bit of extra. For one, it's a waste. But you could just keep wrapping right to the end. And as soon as you hit the end of the wire, it just snaps itself. It breaks. Which is perfect. It cuts itself right off. But at this point, I've gone this little extra. What I can do here is get my fingers out of there now. See that wire coming off here, and what I'll do, just take my clippers and cut it off, and you see it's fine. Some people have stated that you should overlap it, get to there, and then you know, wrap it this way some, wrap it back and forth a little bit to secure it. I've done that. You're even a little extra. This is going to be an end, and the end we started off is going to be an end. So most likely, they're going to get cut and thrown away regardless. So it doesn't really matter here. As you can see, it wrapped and stayed. That's it, guys. So let's get this out of the drill and meet back down at the table. Here is our finished Clapton. What we can do is, our finished fuse Clapton. Okay, we can take that out of the drill now. Let's get the drill out of the way because we are all done with that. Get that right out of the way. And as you can see with this wire, you can see, let me see if I can get close up for you. There's all kinds of twists in it. See that going all down it? It just twisted and twisted and twisted and twisted. So what we want to do here is take, you're going to need two sets of pliers for this. Alright. And at one end, we're going to hold it in the flat spot. And then what we can do is take our pliers and just twist it straight. Okay. And down just a little bit. Pinch on. Twist it to straighten it. And you can see this end already is a lot straighter. Okay. I'll show you guys a little bit more and then send you on your way to do it. We just grab there, pinch here, straighten it out. Okay. Now it doesn't have to be straight as an arrow. You don't want it as twisted as it is because you're going to go to wrap your coil. And you're going to have a twisted fuse Clapton at that point. Because you're going to go to spin it on your bit. And there's going to be twists all over it. So you want this. You're going to see. It's something that you just have to feel out. As you go down this wire, it's going to, you're going to go down this wire and it's, like I said, it's not going to stay straight as an arrow. You're going to see that. Say if I'm twisting right here, up here has a little twist in it, if you can see. It's twisting almost 40, you know, a quarter of the way. It's flat here. You can see my fingers are flat. And then it's spun out this way. That little bit is not that big of a thing to worry about. I mean, you can do a long bend and grab your pliers. If I wiggle a little bit, I've noticed it helps. It's all subjective, though. Everybody has their different ways. This is my way. You know, if you check out local vape, Homeboy OC, he has his way of doing fused Claptons. Grim Green has his way. You know, everybody's got a different method. A lot of people use the swivel method, which I just picked up some swivels, so I might give that a shot. I really got that to try and do some staggered fuse Claptons and some staggered staples, and I wanted to try and do some staggered builds, so I picked up some swivels, the ball bearing swivels. If anybody's thinking about it, make sure they're the ball bearing swivels. All right. So you've seen that I've gotten this so far big chunk, and it's common sense. It really is. Just go on down, you know, pinch a little bit, get it straightened. Go to just before your next bend, pinch it, pinch there, twist it to straighten, okay? Alright, and I know this looks crazy. This is the fuse Clapton wire. After going down and straightening everything, it got, instead of all these little teeny twists in here, it just kind of became one big twist, but the rest of the wire is straight. I know what this looks like. After straightening all that canthal, it looks crazy, but as soon as you coil it, that completely becomes irrelevant. So let's grab us a bit and wrap up some coils. Let's go into our bit set. And this is a build that's going to go on the Kennedy 22. So I think that a 3mm bit is acceptable because the Kennedy has some build room. So what we can do now It's this crazy end that never got wrapped. Take your cutters and trim that guy off. Get rid of that. Okay. Now we can take our bit. And we have plenty of wire here, so leave yourself a lead. Okay, definitely leave yourself some of a lead. And I always like to pinch it with my finger and start our wraps. Like to leave it with my fingernail so that when we come around this first wrap, we have room to wrap it in there. Okay. So there's two wraps. We're going to go to six. There's three. There's four. And there's five. All right. So this is going to be a six-wrap fuse Clapton. Here's our coil. And you can see all this extra wire hanging off. That's going to be our second coil. Leave yourself one lead longer than the other. Trim that just shy of it. You got plenty of lead there on both. You go ahead and slide that off. Put it to the side. Go on and do the same thing for your second coil. And here is our two six-wrap fuse Claptons. Okay. Just as a recap, we're going to end this down here on the table. There's no need to go back to FaceTime. We will see you in part two. To wrap this up, though, we have a 26-gauge core, but for a fuse Clapton, there's two strands for the core. So we have two 26-gauge wires for the core wrapped in 36-gauge nichrome 80. Okay, it is a six wrap on a 3mm bit to be installed on the Kennedy 22. All right, I thank you guys so much for watching this tutorial. I hope it was as helpful as possible to anybody out there looking for a pointer or just a new way of doing it. Okay, please make sure to join me back here for the second part of this video. The review of the Kennedy 22. We will be installing these into that RDA and reviewing it. So I want to do a giveaway. I haven't really done any giveaways. I'm getting a few videos in there. I'm very light on the subscribers, but what I want to do is I'm going to send a set of fuse Claptons and a set of staple coils. So you're going to get four coils all together, two staples, two fuse Claptons, okay? I'm going to do that at 20 subscribers. So if you watch my subscribers, if I'm not at 20 yet, I haven't picked anybody. On this video, if you would like to enter to win a set of these fuse Claptons and staple coils, just put some kind of comment down in the comment section, okay? And when I reach 20 subscribers, I will pick one at random out of the comments of who has commented. I will pick that lucky winner. I will message you, get a hold of you somehow. And I will send you a set again of fused Claptons and a set of staples. Thanks for watching, guys. Remember to comment, hit that subscribe button for a chance to win. And we will see you back here for part two on the Kennedy. All right, vape on, guys.